In this video, we'll give an example of how to use Simpson's rule to integrate, and we'll do this using a spreadsheet. And the idea is we have a number of discrete data points, so we cannot integrate analytically. We have to do it numerically. However, to demonstrate how this works, we'll use a function that we could integrate analytically, and then we'll generate data points from that function, and then we'll compare this to a spreadsheet. So the function, simple polynomial function, and what we want to do is integrate from 0 to 2.8. So just a standard showing the integration here, applying the limits where we substitute 2.8, and then of course all the terms are 0 at the other limit. And so the integral, which of course here's the function, corresponds to the area under the curve, is 5.8856. So for Simpson's rule, we're going to assume we only have these data points that's indicated here, and we don't know what the function is, so we want to integrate it numerically. And the approach is, let's start here. We'll create an interval, so we'll call this h, this interval, and then we'll integrate over every 2h. So for example, easy to show here, from here to here, so 0.4, to 0.8, this area we'll get from Simpson's rule, and we'll get this area and so forth. And also we'll do it here to get this area. But let's look at just this one. What we do in Simpson's rule to get that area, we'll take h over 3 times the function evaluated at the lower limit. In this case, the function evaluated 0.4 plus 4 times the function evaluated at 0.6 plus the function evaluated at the upper limit, 0.8. And that's going to be a pretty good approximation. Essentially, you were saying, or the way we could look at this is h times 2 multiplied by the same function and then divided by 6. So we evaluate this function 6 times and divide it by 6. We're getting an average that weights towards the middle value. And then we're multiplying by 2.8. So if you like, for this integration from 0.4 to 0.8, we're saying our beginning area x from 0.4 to 0.8. And then the function is some average value, where we get that average value by taking 4 times the function here plus this function and dividing by 6. And then we'll just step along doing that, and we'll do this on a spreadsheet. And so we'll switch over to the spreadsheet. So here's the spreadsheet where we have data just every 2/10 in x values. We calculated the function. And then we're assuming we don't actually know the form of the function. We just have this set of data points where the interval, the h interval, is 0.2. Then to apply Simpson's rule, we'll say from 0 to 0.4, we look at this cell. We have h, which we named here. So we named this value h. We have h divided by 3 multiplied by d5, which is here. And then it's going to be plus 4 times d6, which is this value, plus d7, which is this value here. So this is the integral from here to here. And then all we've done is copy this and paste it here, 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 and here. Every other one, because the interval is 2/8 that we integrate over. This cell is just the sum of these values to get the total interval. And you notice that we get 5.8856, actually the same value we get from our analytical solution. So the Simpson's rule, particularly for a well-behaved function, works quite well. We could certainly do this with fewer data points. The idea is the same. As the number of data points decreases, of course, the accuracy should go down. But when we've made experimental measurements and we have measurements, some values for, say, this is time and this is concentration, we don't have any functional form, then we can use Simpson's rule to get the area under the curve or the integral of f of x dx.